Hello, my crafty friends. It's Beverly here over at Crafting Chaos again. I bet you get sick of your life seeing me this week. But as promised, I'm back with the shark card that I've been asked to design as a special request. Now, in the video, I'm going to be making the shark, and I'll show you how to do that, how to make the shaped card. And I'll also be throwing in some little embellishments into the file that I add to my download page. I'll be putting links to my video that show you how to make the seaweed, which I've done in a previous video. So all those things can be found tracing. It includes tracing the file and bringing it in to, so you can bring it into Canvas from a PNG or a JPEG and trace the file. So I'm just showing you what we've got so far and what we're aiming for. So I'm just moving, I'm going to delete some of these parts. This is just incidentally, this is a card that I made that kind of goes with it. If I just undo it, you can see. And all I did was make a basic blank card. And then I created this layer that has like a shaped edge, a welded shaped edge with the starfish and the shell with the star in the middle. And then I made a cut like so from it so that I could actually have two layers, in that then one looked like the sand and the other looked like the ocean, so I could have an underwater scene. If you're interested in knowing how to make that card, then I can do another video on that, but I haven't got that one at the moment. I just put it there. I have got it in my somewhere in my projects. As you see, I've got sneaky peek on the Christmas ones over here. I've started on them. I've done some more designs further down, just a sneak peek of what's coming for Christmas. So these are all the designs that we've been making, and some extra designs. There's one that we're going to be making, the Rudolph, and we've got a nativity scene, a sleigh card's coming up. So we've got lots of things coming up for Christmas, so I hope you're looking forward to the Christmas series. So I'm trying to do 12 projects of Christmas, but we'll see how far I get. So that's the plan, but I'm hoping to get them done in time for yous to make them for Christmas, because it's pointless me doing them in December and then you've got all your cards to make. So I'm just moving some things off to the side that I don't need. I'm going to keep one of the sharks, I think, for reference, just because it'll help to jog my memory on how I made the shark. I'm just going to delete those. And I'm going to delete the ornaments. Again, like I say, I'll include those in the download. And we're just going to keep with the shark for now. So I'm just grouped him. Oh, I thought I had. Hang on, I'll undo that and just select everything and group. And I'll ungroup him later. Okay. So that's where we're up to. And let's get started. So now, I'm going to get this back on so I can get to my basic shapes. Feel a bit slow. I'm not quite with it yet this morning, but I'm getting there. It's a holiday feeling, I think, being on half term, and my nerves are just unwrangling. All right, so we're going to make a start on the shark. So first of all, you need to bring on a basic shape. And it's this one I use quite a lot in my paper piecing files, and I call it the egg shape. And I'm just going to click, I'm going to ungroup him. I'm actually going to make him a little bit bigger so it's easier to make. Gives me the bit more leeway to play with, because you can shrink him down whenever you, as long as you don't go too small for the nostrils. And if you do want to do it really small, leave that little bit and the pupils out. That way then you can just draw them in with a black pen, and you're not going to be putting too much strain on your blade trying to do too small of a circle. I think it's something like 3mm it needs to turn the blade in the holder, but I'm not certain. So like I say, we're starting with this egg shape, and I'm just going to widen it out a little bit, and I'm going to check it on for size with my shark. So I'm just aiming to get it roughly. It doesn't have to be exact, because it's still going to look okay. I'm just going to make it slightly narrower. Just try that on once more. Yeah, I'm happy with that. So we'll go with that, and I've got it. That egg shape now is 4.33 inches by 5.33 inches. Okay, so that's where we're starting from. So the next thing I did was bring in this shape to make the fins. And all I did was stretched it out for the dorsal fins. I'm not sure what they might be, pectoral fins. I get a bit confused with the fins on fish. But there you have it. So what I'm going to do now is centre both of those together. So edit and centre them. And then I'm going to weld them like so. So that's giving us this fin shape here. So I'm just going to double click that. And all I did then was just to give them a little bit of added shape. I just dragged the nodes down here a little bit. And you've seen me working with nodes before. And you can make them go whichever way you choose. So I'm just, oops, not that way. Just hit the handle by accident then. If it helps, hide the handles. So I think I'm fairly happy with that. I'd like it to go a little bit more upwards really, but it's not wanting to. So I'm going to leave it like that for now. Okay, so that's your basic shark shape for the top. Then we need a shark fin. And what I used for that was the sort of rounded out rectangle. Triangle. I'll get there in a minute. Just bear with. So I'm just going to shrink that in and I'm going to position that in the centre of the shark. Select both, edit and line them on the vertical axes. And then I'm going to edit, process the overlap and weld. So I'm just going to make that a little bit bigger. Sometimes you can see better once you've actually welded how big your shapes are and if you're happy with them. So again, I'm going to select everything by just pulling the cursor across everything. And then I'm going to go to edit and we're going to align it to the vertical axes again. And then we're going to edit, process the overlap and weld. So that's given us the basic shape for our shark, like so. So now we're going to work on the shark's... Oh, before I need to do that, I'm just going to undo. Because I actually need, silly Billy, the mouth. So I'm just going to undo that. Okay, so I'm going to select that, duplicate. It's always a good idea to duplicate your shapes. And I speak from the heart when I say that, because I just wonder if I can get it to flip. And then if I flip this one, how would that look? No, they still point down, don't they? So, I'm going back to the stage where I could weld the pectoral fins together. And I'm going to line them on the vertical axes. And I'm probably saying that wrong. It's probably not the pectoral fins. I'm probably remembering it all wrong. Bring on that triangle again. Shrink it down. Put it on our shark. Till I think it looks about right. Select both again by drawing round all of them. Go to edit and we're going to align on the vertical axes and then we're going to edit, process the overlap and weld. So we're back to where we started from now. Next we're going to work on the shark's mouth, and the reason I needed this is because I want it to be a perfect fit for that layer underneath. So what I'm going to do now is bring on a basic rectangle. And I'm just going to use, as you've seen me do this many times before in videos, using a shape to cut another shape. And as long as the shape that you're using as your scissors, as it were, is on top, it's going to work for you. So all I'm doing is going to chop off a part of that egg shape that's the same size as the shark's head. I'm going to edit and remove the overlap. And there we have that. Now, all I did then was I'm going to take a duplicate, then I don't make the same mistake again. Double click, and I need to, when I double click, it will expose the nodes, and I want this top one selecting, and I'm going to add a node, and that will add a node right at the centre. And all I'm going to do now is click and just pull down ever so slightly to give us that sort of angle there. Okay, so all I'm going to do next is I'm going to make a duplicate of that. And I can delete this one now because I don't need it. And I'm going to turn that one black so we can see where we're going. So that would be the back part, if you will. Now for this part, what we need to do is create an offset. So we're going to go on to edit, create an offset. And we're going to make it inwards by about, I think we'll try 0.2 and see how that looks. and then we can always reduce it if needs be. And I think that's perfectly fine. So now we need to make sure that our that one is in on top, and it is. And we're going to select both of those by just drawing around those two. And you literally only need to just catch the two in the corner, if you see where my little square is shaded in on the screen, and that will select both of them for you. And then I'm going to do a process, the overlap and subtract. And remember, that's effectively punching that middle shape out of the shape underneath. So what I'm going to do now is click on that shape, and I'm going to colour as I go, because I find that easier than because then I can see where I'm going with everything. You don't have to do this step if you're fine. I just feel I work better this way, but that's entirely your choice. So now I'm going to do this. I'm going to make a duplicate of that one. That's going to be the mouth, if you will, there, that part. And now we're going to work on the shark's teeth. And in order to do that, I actually pulled on this shape, which I think looks a little bit like a shark's tooth. And I'm going to shrink it down like so, shrink it in a little bit, and then I'm going to see how it fits in the mouth, because what I'm wanting it to do is overlap with this blue one, if you will, like so. And it's just a little bit big, so I'm just going to shrink it down a little bit more. You can either do this with your dragging from one of these handles, what we call these little dots going around the shape. If you drag from a corner, it does it proportionally. If you drag it from the side, it'll stretch just that side. So I'll undo that, just for people. I'm sure most of you know that anyway, but just in case. So again, before I start doing any duplicates, I'm going to try it for size, and I think that's going to be okay. So I'm going to hit D a few times, and we're going to keep a spare over there, and then we're going to start arranging the teeth into the shark's mouth. And this is all I did, was line them up so that, oops, I've moved that one, just resized it. So if that happens, you've always got your undo arrow, and I use that a lot. So then I'm going to move the shark's teeth into position on the mouth, like so. And I think we can have another one here, maybe. Just going to make it a little bit smaller for going on the edges and duplicate it. I'm going to rotate it ever so slightly so I can fit it in. And we're there. And then we'll do the same but the opposite rotation here. And that's the bottom row of teeth, if you will. Okay, so that's that completed. Now I'm going to edit and flip. And just select the tooth that I want, which is this one. Edit and flip. Now, if this happens, and I have no idea why this actually does happen, but sometimes your options grey out like this for no reason. What you need to do, if this happens to you, don't panic and start again. Just give the project a title, like Shark. Make sure you click on this icon to save it to your online where you save your online files, and say okay. Then if you do the refresh button, which is something like this, you'll probably have something similar on whichever browser you have. If you just use that refresh icon, it will refresh everything on your screen, and you panic for a minute thinking you've lost it, but then it comes back. And usually then when you click on your grayed out items return. I have no idea why that happens, so I'm going to click that one because obviously I want these to be pointing down. I'm going to duplicate it a few times, and then I'm going to start fitting it in between the other teeth, as it were, that are already in position. Again, overlapping with the blue part so that you can see what's happening. I'm just positioning the teeth. Then I'm going to shrink these two. I'm going to shrink that one. Shrink one down and duplicate it for these bits. Again, I'm just going to rotate that ever so slightly using that's what that green dot does. It rotates things for you, so you can either do a free rotation like so, doing it your own angle, or you could use it angling from the properties box. So if I clicked on a tooth, you could angle wherever you want, but when I'm doing it by eye like that, I like to position them myself because they're not going to be perfect in reality. So I'm just going to move that out of my way so I can select. I don't know why I keep saying collect, I mean select. I'm just going to, again, select everything, including the teeth, and I'm going to go to edit and weld. And that kind of welds the teeth to that. So we're going to make those view, show properties box, and we're going to make the teeth white. Now, so really the mouth is actually in three layers. So if I bring this one to the top, because that's going to be sort of where it's rolling its lips back almost. Can line those up. In fact, we can line everything up now. Edit, and we line them vertical and horizontal axes. And that's created the shark's mouth. So if we put that into position, it should just fit perfect. Oh, and you can do this by using your arrow key if you want to see what it's looking like on the screen. So we'll make the shark background colour now, and we'll make it blue. That's the colour I went for my shark. Oh, not that blue. I don't like that one. And it puts me off if it's not the right colour on screen. So there we have it. So I'm going to select everything. I'm going to drag it down. We haven't grouped those, have we? If you have grouped them, you can ungroup. I didn't think we had. Oh, we haven't. So there we have the three separate layers that make up the teeth. So what we need to do now is work on the shark's nose and eyes. So again, just basic shapes, and we're just wanting circles this time. We'll just wait for the machine to catch up. So we're going to click on a circle. I'm going to shrink it down till it's roughly the same as my other eye. So I'm just going to test it. That's about right. And I'm going to duplicate it. I'm going to put them roughly where I want them. And then I'm going to select them both. I'm going to line them up to the top. And then I'm going to group them. And then I'm going to click on the shark, and I'm going to line them up on the vertical axis so I know that they're in the middle. So if I click on them again, I can now turn them to white so that we've got that part done. So then I'm going to edit and ungroup them. I'm just going to click on the one for now, duplicate it. I'm going to shrink it down so that I'm making the pupil. So that's about 0.38 we've got it at the minute. We'll see what that looks like. So click off and position that into the eye. And we're going to duplicate that and again move that into position for the other eye. And then I'm going to take a duplicate of the pupil. And I think I made these about 0.25. Like so. And I'm going to then put those. I'm just going to zoom in a little bit because it's making it difficult to move. So I'm just going to, whoops, not so much. View fit to matte if that happens, and then zoom in again. It's only because I didn't click on the selection tool again before I went on the map that happens. So I'm going to duplicate that. I'm going to position the nose pieces like so. And you can do all the fancy lining up stuff, but remember, you're going to be sticking them on your card anyway. So view fit to matte, and that's how we're looking. So next we're going to work on the shark's tail. So for that, I brought on, let me find it. This shape. Oops. This shape, I think. Have I brought it on twice? Yes, I have. So I'll just get rid of that for now. And all I did was I kind of stretched it out and made it longer. And then I used a rectangle or a square just to chomp the end off. We've lost it somehow. So I used that to just chomp the end off. So I positioned it at that pointy end, edit and remove the overlap. Like so. And then I brought in the circle. So I'm just going to bring in the circle. I'm just going to delete that square so I don't end up. I'm going to view fit to matte, and then we can see what we're doing. I'm going to use the circle, and I'm going to duplicate it. I'm going to place one over the other, like so. And then I'm not selecting the sharp, but just the circles. Line them up on the vertical axes and edit, and I want to subtract. So that'll leave us with that. So all I did then was bring in that piece and highlighted that piece we've just made, lined them up vertically, and I welded them together. So that's given us our sort of this shape here, almost. And then all I did was rotate it, brought it into position, like so, however you want it. It might be a little bit big. If you can always, you can always shrink it down to a size that suits you. I'm going to edit and send it right down to the very back, and I'm going to turn it blue, like so. So like I say, that's the basic shark file completed. You can have it a bit narrower if you wish. Just play with it until you're happy. No, they're never going to be exactly identical to the first one you make, but they're thereabouts. So that's your basic shark. Now, if we go back to my projects and we look at the shark file, if I can find it. It's in here somewhere. I actually think I've just overwritten it. Oh no, it's here. So what I did then was created this background card for it to fit on. So all I did for that, again, you've guessed it, it's my favourite shape, especially for this sort of thing, is I used the egg shape, like so. I shrank it down, so it's roughly the same as the shape as the shark itself. So I'm just going to do that. And you could refer to the dimension that I gave you. It doesn't have to be exact, just thereabouts, and I'm happy with that. And all I'm going to do now is just select all of my shark, group it for now so I can move it off to the side. And what I'm going to do with this is I made it about 5.5 by 5.5 by about 4. So I'm just going to increase the size a little bit just so it's a little bit bigger. So something like that. And then all I did, in fact, did I do it 6? That looks more like it. I just wanted to make sure that it fits on the mat. So then I did 2 duplicates of it. I then aligned the 2 to the top, 2 of them to the top. And then I unclicked one, moved one across until they're just overlapping, like so. Then I clicked on that and clicked edit and weld, like so. So what we've got now is our basic card shape. We just need to add a score line. So I'm going to click on this, make your node tool here. I'm going to click and hold my shift key down, drag it out. And when I get to the other side, I'm going to double click to anchor it. And if it doesn't select it automatically, if you click on this selection zooming in tool, it selects it for you. So when I'm going to go onto my properties box, which is this icon here, and I'm going to go make it a cutting line and a perforating line, because that's the one that I want it to be. So then I'm going to select the perforated line and the backing file, and I'm going to group them so that then I can move that now independently. So then if we make that a colour, for example, let's make it like an aqua colour for argument's sake, like so, this will then be a perfect matting layer for on top, like so. Now, because remember, when you fold that where you've welded it there, that's going to be missing, and having this second layer, and I've shown you this plenty of times on my other cards, so you should be getting the idea of what it's for now, so that when that card's folded, you're still going to have the full thing there. Now what you can do then, if you want, is make a matting layer for it. So just by create, sorry, I'm just going too fast again, aren't I? So again, clicking on that, then I'm edit and creating an offset, which is this icon. And I'm just going to make it about 0.08 and say okay. Well, that doesn't seem to have changed shark size to me. Let's just have a look. 4.83 and 4. Yes, it has. It's just that it's at the bottom for some reason. We're going to bring that to the top. So that one's smaller than that one. For some reason, it went underneath, and it doesn't normally do that, so it threw me a little bit. Usually brings it in on top. So I'm just going to select that one, maybe make it a shade lighter so we can see the matting layer, like so. So that's all going to mat onto your base card. And then all I did was bring the shark in, shrank it down, and then I'm going to bring it to the top, fit it on my card like so. And like I say, what I would do then is just edit and ungroup, check the size of your smallest part, and that's 0.12. so if you work out what 0.12 is in millimeters, it's just over 3, so we're okay. You'd be okay to cut that, but that's probably about the smallest you'd want to go for that particular piece. So obviously you're all right with the eyes, they could go a bit smaller, but this one, that's about as small as you'd want to go for the nostrils, if you will. Otherwise it could struggle getting round, because they don't recommend you try to cut anything smaller than a 3mm circle. I'm sure that's what it says in the literature. So all I did then was created a sentiment called, and I did your possum. So I just brought in my type converter software. I typed in your possum, just to play on words really, because I thought, not possum, jawsome, that was it. That was possum was for a dog card that I did, Jawsome. So then click save wherever you wanted to save it. I used the Europe underground font, which I got from the font. So I'd saved it, preview it, and that's a single line font, and I thought, and it's not too fancy, which I didn't want it to be for this particular card. I've already saved it, so I'm not going to save it again. Then you'll be able to locate it using your SVGs, open, choose the file, wherever you've saved it. I suggest saving it to your desktop or possibly. I have my files located in my backup drive. Somewhere in here it is. I'm going to search for it, possum. Jawsome. There we are. So I can click on that and then say open. As you can see, where we're up to now, just before we got interrupted by the dog barking, I've hopefully edited that bit out, and you can see that we're at the point where we've just brought the greeting in from this, where it was saved on the computer, until we're just about to sort it out now so that we can actually use it. So I'm just moving what we've got out of the way. So like I said, I've brought in You Are Jawsome, and the font I've used is called Europe Underground, and it's a single line font. So I'm going to select everything and then I'm going to add some colour so we can see what we're dealing with. And when we add the colour, you can see, same problem, we've had this loads and loads of times, but I keep trying to run you through it so that hopefully eventually it'll stick. What you need to do is remove the red parts that would also colour in once you'd set it to draw. It'd actually draw that fill as well, because when you do that, that's when you're doing this fill function here, it would draw it as well. So we're going to click on each letter where we can see this issue, and we're going to go edit, process the overlap, and we're going to subtract. So we're going to do that on each of the offending letters, and hopefully then we're left with our words. So what I tend to do then is group them as words, so group them as individual words like so, so that you can arrange them on your page or project wherever you want. What I do then is just select everything and group them all together, but no, it's just group the three words. So when I ungroup them, it'll ungroup them to three words again. We can then resize if we need to fit our project. And then I'm going to click ungroup, and then that, as you see, gives us back our three words already grouped together, the letters, so we're not dealing with that. So I'm just going to look, line those up vertically and horizontally, and I'm going to move them into position. Then I'm going to put the words on. Oops, just the U. U. And then we're going to do the R. And then draw some. And you can, I'm going to just select the whole shark now and group it so I can move it as one and move him into position, as you see, and then I'll ungroup it for the purpose of the file. And you can see now you've got your greeting intact, and I'm just going to move everything so it's onto the mat. I can delete my original shark now. Oops. Would help if I delete them all, otherwise it won't let me download it. So that's where we're up to then. Now, in my original file, I did include some things, and I'm just going to scroll down till I just have a look through my project so I can find them. They're quite a way back, so it might take me a few seconds, but as I'm going down, you can have a quick prelude of all the projects that we've been covering, or I may cover. Oops, now I've brought that on, I didn't mean to do that. This is when I wish I had my singing head on and I could sing while we're waiting to get to where we're going. Okay, we're nearly there now. So, just going back right to the very start of my video series, is one of the first videos that I ever did. So it might not be as good as the rest, but, and hopefully I've improved, and hopefully if you did go back and watch these, you would see a big improvement. So this is the file that I'm talking about, this one, and also, actually I bring them, the one with the different ones on. So those are the different seaweeds that I had, and I actually did a video that showed you how to trace, important trace these, and then you can resize them and colour them any size that you wanted, like so. So if I just go, say, view, I can make it nice corally colours or whatever you want to, really. So those were just some that I included in that. Now the other file is not included in the download as such, apart from the fact you're getting the shell, the crab and the seahorse and the shell as little embellishments. But this edge card or edge panel that can be turned into a card, which I had turned it into, you can see is actually another file, and I could actually show you how to do that if there's any interest. So I think we're getting to the point where perhaps this video is long enough. So I'll put all the parts that I said I was going to include. So all the embellishment parts, the shark itself and the shell, the crab and the seahorse. So that you've got some embellishments for your card. Also the greetings on there. And I think you've got everything, the makings of a really neat sort of ocean themed card. Or certainly all of the embellishments could be used in your beach themed scrapbooks. I'm sure you could do a brilliant job with them. And I hope you've enjoyed the video. If you have, please remember to like, share and subscribe if you don't already do so. Remember to tell your friends where I am. It's what keeps me going. I'm just hoping that I am reaching people and that they're enjoying the tutorials and learning. So that's about it for this video. So I hope to see you soon on my channel, and I'll leave a link below to the file of how to create the seaweed if you want to see that in the description box below. And remember, I'll leave a link to my blog at in the information box underneath my recorded videos, where you can download all of the files that I produce on the YouTube channel, are there and free to download. I also include extras over on my blog that I don't include on YouTube, so it is worth a look if you're interested. All right, so I'll see you soon. Bye.